Now let's look at the combination of fundamental and psychological impact that market corrections have on share prices of our portfolio companies, right? So let me first explain what this chart is all about. This chart was, by the way, published I think 8-9 months back in one of our newsletters of Consistent Compounders. So this chart shows you on the vertical axis Asian Paints' share price movement for each financial year over the last 40 years, and on the horizontal axis Sensex's movement as an index in the same year over the last 20 years. So there are 20 dots on this chart. For each dot, the vertical axis value is the Asian Paints share price movement, horizontal axis value is the Sensex index movement. Yeah. Dots on the left show you years where Sensex delivered a negative return, right? Dots on the bottom of the horizontal line show you years when Asian Paints delivered a negative return in a financial year. Now, few very interesting conclusions here. So Sensex delivered a negative return in 6 out of the last 20 years. Yeah. By the way, you can do the same thing for the last 25 years period or 30 years period. The last 25 year analysis we've shown in our book Coffee Can Investing. Last 20 years have had 6 years of negative return for Sensex. In Paint, over the same 20 year period, has had only 2 years of negative return. Right? What that has meant, and you can see those which are in the bottom left quadrant, right? What that has meant is there are several dots which are to the left of the vertical axis, which means Sensex was in the negative, but above the horizontal axis, which means Asian Paints was still positive, right? So there are 4 out of the last 6 years of stock market crash when Asian Paints delivered a positive return, right? I repeat, so 2/3 of the instances of stock market crash led to Asian Paints still delivering a positive return, right? Now, this is when Asian Paints has always traded at a substantial premium to the broader market. 25 years ago, it was at 45 times PE multiple. Today also, it is at a similar PE multiple. Only for a short period of 5-6 years over the last 20 years, it was at a 20-25 times type of a PE multiple. Otherwise, it has always traded at a rich PE, especially relative to the market, very high PE for the entire 20 year period. Right? Now, despite that, this firm has actually not fallen in 2/3 of stock market crashes. More importantly, the last bullet that you see at the bottom, the opportunity loss of missing out from investing in Asian Paints is that 13 out of last 20 years have had more than 20% annual share price return from Asian Paints. Interestingly, 2 out of those 13 years, you can see those dots above the dotted red line, but to the left of the vertical line, right? Top left quadrant above the dotted red line. There are 2 dots which actually were years of Sensex negative, Asian Paints more than 20%, right? So if you sit out waiting for a good entry point during a stock market crash, to begin with, it's a stock market crash and the depth of it and how long it will last. But even if you get that right, sitting out on cash is not advisable in a stock like Asian Paints, because there's a very high probability that not only will Asian Paints deliver a positive return during such a period, it will actually deliver a very healthy positive return of more than maybe 20% during such a period, right? Now, this phenomenon is not unique only to Asian Paints. So in the next slide, what you can see, this exhibit, right? What I explained for Asian Paints on the previous slide has actually applied to every consistent compounder which has been listed for the entire 20-year history from our portfolio, right? All these four companies that you see have demonstrated, if you look at the third last row, a positive return when Sensex was negative. So remember, there were six instances of Sensex negative, and these firms were delivering a positive return most out of the majority of those six instances, right? And majority of the last 20-year period, they've delivered more than 20% absolute return, which has also been in years when Sensex has delivered a negative return, right? So this is something which is actually backed by sound logic. So the logic is very simple. Let's say if Asian Paints' earnings go up by 25% in a year, right? And at the same time, the P multiple for the broader index falls by, let's say, 20%, right? Even if you assume Asian Paints' PE collapses along with the broader market's PE, the correction in the PE multiple will be more than offset by earnings growth for Asian Paints. The same will not be true for a Sensex or a Nifty 50, where the earnings growth is not strong, right? Hence, perhaps the share price fall is a lot more prolonged, right, for the broader index. So that's a simple logic. It's mathematics. We've explained this in our previous newsletters.